Hi, my name is Antonis and I am the iconographer of this video. I hope you are well and healthy and creative in your studio. And for today I will share with you how I paint a very small icon of Virgin Mary. And I'm using a very little board for that. So stay with me if you want to see my process. I will share some tips and advices with you on how to paint a very small icon, something that we very often as iconographers have to do, either because we get a commission of a small icon or a commission of an icon that has many figures and we need to go small. So stay with me, I will share with you some tips and advices, and I hope that you'll find this video helpful. Hi, I'm Antonis, and I'm proud to present you my online course in iconography, Paint an Icon with Me. This course will help you become a better iconographer, and it will help you be more confident when talking and presenting your artwork. It will make you understand in depth the studio practices of a professional iconographer like me, and you will get accustomed to what great iconography looks like. So learn in a simple and organized way everything you need about the materials, mediums, and techniques in order to make a beautiful icon. Paint with me the icon of Christ, and learn how to paint better any icon you wish. I will see you at the studio. So my online course is on. You will find the link of the course on the description of this video below if you are interested. This course will for sure help you become better as an iconographer. I share with you all practically everything I know about iconography there, and I'm pretty sure that it's going to help you improve and become better. Along with the 24 videos, you'll find a bunch of 147 images from the Byzantine painting tradition, mostly of the Cretan style, and I'm pretty sure you will be more aware of how great iconography looks like, and you will be much more you'll have a much better understanding of the process and what great iconography looks like. Anyway, so here you already see me painting, started the painting with this icon. I have transferred my drawing on my board, and now I am doing some very basic underpainting. This holy Maphorion of Maphorion is called this holy cloth of Virgin Mary, Maphorion, and this Maphorion is pretty dark. Its proplasmos, its base color, will be very dark. So I have done a little bit of very light etching on the drapery of Virgin Mary, just because I'm sure that after I apply my proplasmos, this underpainting I'm doing now will be lost. Of course, somebody can ask then why you do it at all, this drapery with the brush. Why don't you begin by applying the proplasmo directly without any underpainting, since you have etched the drapes? I would say that doing this warms me up. It's like when you do a workout, you do some warming before. It's the same thing here. I warm up my muscles to handle the brush and to paint the details of this icon. So, as I say, nothing is lost. The more time you spend before an icon, sitting on your easel, the better, in my opinion. And no practice is useless and without any merit. So, as you see, I'm doing this underpainting, and this will help me understand better later on how to proceed, how to keep the brush, and which areas of this icon get to be in shadow, which areas of this icon get to be in light. You will notice that I'm using a very small brush, size 0, and I will pretty much paint this whole icon using this same brush. With just one brush, I will finish this little icon. I do hope you are well and healthy, as I said before. I have to say that I'm a little worried about things lately. Although the weather becomes better and it's really nice, things with our health can be a little tricky. So take care of yourselves and try to be creative, try to be balanced. And of course, iconography really, really helps with that a lot. Sometimes when I talk with people who really are stressed and anxious about things, I think of my studies, I think of my icons, I think of my materials and mediums, of our subject, of course, itself, and this makes me more strong. This gives me power to continue and also share this strength with other people. So again, I would say we are so lucky to be artists, to be iconographers, and to have a chance to express ourselves through that amazing gift that we are given. So after having done my underpainting with pure black, as you saw, I painted this whole cloth of Virgin Mary with epoplasmo, that consists of black, a little bit of cadmium red, and a little bit of Mars red. This Maphorion, this proplasmos, has to be, in my opinion, and in the opinion of my reference, very dark, dark brown, and of course, since it is so black, so dark, I've lost most of my underpainting beneath, but I have done a light etching, as I told you, and this will help me paint now the grapsimata, the darker folds of the cloth of Virgin Mary here. I want to thank you so much for being around in this channel, for your amazing comments. Many of you ask very thoughtful questions, and the comments you share are really to the point and amazing. So thank you so much. All of you are very supportive of these videos, and this really gives me much strength to continue. So thank you for subscribing. If you haven't yet, please do. And like this video below. It's really rewarding and helps me a lot. I'm also very happy when you send me your progress, your icons in my email account, and also, it's very nice when I see that in the comment section below, you also answer other people's questions. This is also very nice. And since the comments and the messages come to me in more and more, there are so many messages, it's always nice to see that many of you answer other people's questions in the section of the comments below. So thank you so much for participating in this community, And I do hope that little by little we will become more and more supportive of each other. Of course, I have to thank those of you who have already bought my online course. Thank you really so much for trusting me as your teacher for this for your journey to learning iconography. It's an honor for me, and I do hope that this course will satisfy you and you will learn many things from that. Again, thank you all for having bought the course. So now, after I've painted these γραψίματα, I will also do a very light shadowing on the Holy Maphorion, using a very dark and very thin color. I will observe my reference and see which areas of this Maphorion need to be in the dark. And after having finished these γραψίματα, I will also cover every other area with the appropriate προπλασμό. For example, on her hands, I will place this brown, ochre brownish προπλασμό, and on around the face, this consists from yellow ochre, some carmine red, and some black. Just a tiny little bit. You can also add a little bit of cadmium yellow in it. It's a brown orangey color that will accept chrysocotyles, some lights with color or gold leaf later on. Before proceeding with painting any lights, either on the face or on the cloth, I like to having covered everything with some προπλασμό. And then I will create a προπλασμό for the face and the hands of Virgin Mary. These προπλασμός will be a dark brown greenish color. I will use yellow ochre, some black, and a little bit of cadmium yellow. This cadmium yellow in combination with the black will give me a very nice greenish little hue on the color, and I will take some attention to the consistency of the color. I want to be able to having nicely covered these flesh areas with two layers of color. I don't want my color to be very runny, very thin, nor to be extremely thick, but rather having a nice silky consistency that will allow me to cover nicely the face with two layers. As you see here, with one layer it's already nice. I could leave it just like that, but as you see here on the hands, it needs to be one more coat of color. I've lost most of the facial characteristics with this process, but some of them are still visible, and I will paint the γραψίματα in a very different I will have a different approach here to paint the γραψίματα. I just want to place these facial characteristics in their correct place. That's my preoccupation, to try to find where to place the iris, but I'm not preoccupied to really paint them so perfectly as if I had to paint a bigger icon. So I don't worry if I don't paint the mouth in every of its detail, or if I don't paint the nose perfectly in its shape. I just want to make sure that the size of the nose, the size of the eyes are correct, and just place them in the correct area. So after I'm done with covering everything with a basic προπλασμό and the γραψίματα, I will move on with painting the lights in every area of the icon, the clothes, and then after the face. For this first light in the Holy Maphorion, I will create a color that consists of cadmium red, a little bit of the προπλασμό of the Maphorion, that is some I will add a little bit of black in this first light. So I will have some black, some cadmium red, and some Mars or iron oxide red. And with this color I will paint very softly. I will try to establish the first basic shapes of these lights. And as you see directly, the Holy Maphorion of Virgin Mary takes shape, takes some volume, and becomes very, very nice. Try to observe your reference as much as possible. Try to see the shapes of these lights, and try to also understand these shapes, which ones belong to the first light, which ones belong to the second or to the third, if there is any third. Sometimes we will have to create the illusion of γραψίματα, of darker folds, just by painting with just by painting these first lights. Many of the γραψίματα are not made by actually painting a γράψιμο, but they are mostly created by painting the first light around an imaginary γράψιμο. This is very hard for me to to explain, especially with so poor English, but maybe some other time with a bigger icon. So after that, I will create a second, I will create a color that is thinner, much thinner, and a little bit darker. And with that thinner color, I will try to do a little bit of blending between this first light and my προπλασμό. I don't need much brush strokes here, just a little tiny touch, and the blending is there. This is something I do also when I have to paint a larger icon. I think this looks nice. This looks as a nice base for the next light to come and be placed on. So now I'm doing this second light again. I'm using the same brush, the same size brush, and I will now observe again my reference, and I will try to recreate these beautiful shapes of the second light that I see. This second light is a little thicker, a little denser than the first light. I want this to have a fuller body, let's say, to be thicker. And this consists, I just added some cadmium red on the first light, and just that. When we paint a small icon like this one, I know it's harder. We have to control better our muscles, let's say, the way we move the brush, etc. But the advantage is that the icon proceeds much quicker. It's more quick to finish, and we see the results more quick. I would say that this icon took me around 5 hours to draw, to transfer, and then to paint. The whole process took me just 5 hours, whereas if I painted this same icon much larger, it would take me much more time. This is a very satisfying process to see this beautiful red on Virgin Mary's Maphorion. Again, you can do some very little blending on this second light if you like, just very little. The more we go lighter on a cloth, the less blending we do. And now I'm doing this third light. It's really satisfying to paint this third light. For this, I've added on my second light a little bit of cadmium red, and in this case, I will add a little bit of titanium white. Normally, when I'm painting the Holy Maphorion of Virgin Mary, I do not add any white as lighting color. I will lighten the color by adding some cadmium yellow or some yellow ochre, but on my reference here, I'm pretty sure that Andreas Ridzos, the iconographer, of course, of this amazing icon, has added some white to lighten the shapes of this Maphorion. So I will follow his advice here and add a little bit of white, not very much, just so little to see this difference in value. As you see, I'm using this same brush, just working on the tip of it. I know that this can be very intimidating, very hard for some people to achieve. For me as well, it's really hard to paint so small, but little by little, I think, and with practice, we will be much better. So when we paint this small, make sure that you use the brush in a very light way. Always painting, always paint with the tip of the brush, and try to use just a little bit colors that are a little bit lighter than the usual ones. I mean thinner, not lighter, thinner. More runny and more liquid. This will help you very much control your brush, especially if you know how much how your brush behaves and how loaded your brush is. So one of the practices that I do is that I have a piece of cloth on my easel, and I will always wipe a little bit my brush on that piece of cloth, just to unload some of the excess color that my brush might have. So here I am doing this third light, and this could be the end of the painting of the Maphorion. I've seen many icons in the museum here in Heraklio being lit like that. It's really nice. But after observing carefully the reference, I saw that I should have added one layer that is stronger in value, lighter in value, before doing that third light, and I decided now to correct that issue. So as you see, I created the color that is darker in value than my third light, but lighter than my second, and this pinkish, beautiful pinkish, very strong light, and with this I will paint one more layer of light. I will paint this layer as if I didn't paint the third light at all. I will place this color as if I am back on step two steps back when I just had painted my second light. This is because after painting this layer, I will add one more layer of I will repeat adding my strongest light. It just felt before that that strong light I had wasn't in consistency with my reference. And so now, as you see, I go back to my strongest light, and I will re-establish these lines that might be lost in the process of correcting the second light. I do hope you understand what I'm doing, and that it makes sense to you, that you understand the why I'm doing this. For me, it's important not just to explain you the how, but also the why, and to make you see why it's good to observe the reference, and how to make some corrections, and more importantly, to why. So now that I'm done with painting the Holy Maphorion, I will proceed with painting the lights on the face of Virgin Mary. Here you see how small this face of Virgin Mary is. It's pretty small, and you see how important is to work on the tip of the brush. I'm not wearing any glasses when I'm painting this, but I really felt that I needed some when I did the study. I'm 43 years old, and little by little I feel that my sight needs some help, some assistance. Of course, not only my sight, many, many other things, but in iconography, sight is very important. So here with the tip of my brush, I will try to establish these shapes of light, these little islands of light on the face of Virgin Mary. I know that this is hard, it's not very easy. It requires some practice and some experience to know how to place these carefully, these shapes of light. So here I'm just trying to see how the brush works, how it just leaves color on the proplasmon of the face. I'm not smearing any color, I'm not blending any color now, I'm just placing color with the tip of my brush. So you understand how important the brush is for this process. And okay, even if we do some mistake, or if you don't place these shapes perfectly, that's okay. That's fine. So as you see now, I define the eyebrows of Virgin Mary. Even if I haven't painted their grapsimata perfectly, I will define these eyebrows now with my brush stroke, with my first light. And the same thing with the shapes of the hand. So I would say, as a general tip, when we paint smaller, is to not try to imitate our process, to imitate exactly what we would do if this icon was big. But for example, now for me it's impossible to really create these shapes around the nails or the fingers in every detail. Of course, some people might be able to do it and to recreate a small icon exactly as if it was a big one. They use magnifying glasses, they are much more experienced, and And they have, of course, the patience to do that. Me knowing my character, I know that I really am not like that. I prefer working on with bigger figures. So what I will do here is I will try to recreate the illusion of these details somehow, if that's possible, to try to recreate these shapes, even if I don't go into such detail with my brush. So here, as you see, I'm doing a first blending color, a color that is in between first light and second light. And with this color, I will blend. And here, I'm doing an even darker blending color that is closer to my plasmo. And I will do this a further blending between the first blending color and my proplasmo, with just a few brush strokes. And that's the charming part of painting small. With just a few to the point brush strokes, we can do a very nice blending. And now I'm doing a third blending color, a color that is closer to my first light. And with few brush strokes, you will see how nice this third color will help the blending process. Now, with a color that is the color of my first light itself, just a tiny little thinner, I will re-establish this first light with very thin, very decisive, to the point brush strokes. And as you see, the blending becomes very nice and interesting. So, I would say that the most important here is to know how your brush behave, and to know what's on your palette, what you are using, what color of your palette you are using, and also the consistency of the color that you are using. Again, some of this first light. And of course, you can always rotate your icon if you work on an easel. You can rotate it and paint in a way that is more comfortable to you. Here, since I'm video recording this process, I didn't want to rotate the icon here. I knew that I would lost some of the position of this icon, so I prefer to kept it in place. As you see, painting this first light and blending it is mostly done. I'm really satisfied. I have to say that in reality the icon looks smoother. Here is a very zoomed in image. And after I'm done with this first light, I will create a very thin color with carmine red and maybe a little bit of cadmium yellow in it, a very thin orangey color. And with this color, I will paint the cheeks very lightly of Virgin Mary. Just make sure that you paint it very, very lightly and carefully. Don't overdo it. You don't want everything to be covered with this glaze of orange color. Little by little, you can do some corrections on the nose, maybe. Make sure though that your color has the right consistency, which in this case has to be a runnier, more thin consistency. And now I'm doing my second light on the face. As you see here, I'm doing this with a very light color. This second light consists of some of the first light with titanium white. So it has yellow ochre, titanium white, a little bit of carmine red in it. So if you find this video helpful, please do subscribe to this channel. I want to thank you so much. You can also find me through my email account, where you can ask me if you are interested for my online mentoring courses. I'm doing some one-to-one lessons through the computer online. If you are interested in that, find me below. And of course, I want to thank all my patrons on patreon.com, where they support me financially and they make these videos possible. Thank you so much for your support there on patreon.com. And if you feel like, you can also visit me there. I upload exclusive content there, and you can support me financially there. So now I did a little bit of blending of this second light to the first light. I created a much thinner color, and with a few brush strokes I tried to blend these two lights together. I would say that the face now it's ready for the final titanium white psimmetria. First, I'll do a little bit of mouth painting. I will create a color that is more orangey, although you can't really see it here, but I want a color that is more orangey for the lower lip of Virgin Mary, and a color that is much more red than brown for the upper lip of Virgin Mary. I'm pretty happy with the outcome of this face so far. It's now you see me painting this final titanium white ψημιθιά. This has to be very, very discreet. Just it should be much contained in as the highlight of the face, and I watch myself painting, and sometimes I have to tell him, hey, stop, but so yes, here I'm painting the highlight of the ψημιθιές, and for the most part icon of Virgin Mary comes to an end. I have to say that although the face is so small, I'm very satisfied with the outcome of these lights. Okay, maybe I should. There are some drawing issues, minor drawing issues here. This is something natural when working so small. But for the most part, I think it's a nice image of Virgin Mary. And now a little bit of the lights in the eyes. Suddenly Virgin Mary takes life. This icon becomes more vivid. And here I add the second light of pure white. This is something that now that I see it on video, I somehow regret doing it, or this second pure white should have should be very much smaller, or I could just leave it with that first light. Again, just a little bit of blending if it feels necessary. Just make sure to not overdo it. Stop now, you know, sometimes, as I said, I feel I need to talk to myself, and now here you can add a little bit of darker color for the γραψίματα if you like, but you can also leave it just the way it is. You can add the darker pupils of in the eyes, or but something. Try to not overdo it. Try to be very careful here. It's better to just omit this darker underlying of the γραψίματα. I feel that the face works just like that. And finally, you can do some of these decorative lines, the χρυσοκοντιλιές, as we call them, and the three stars of eternal virginity of Virgin Mary. So this is the icon of Virgin Mary for the most part. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, that you understood how you can paint something so small,
And you got some inspiration to stay more in your studio. Thank you all so much for your amazing presence in this channel. And I do hope that you progress and you will be creative. I will see you soon with another video tutorial. Until then, be creative and be healthy. Bye.